Hello, hello.
How are you guys? Lenny Gill, Life is No Yoke. It's been a while. Wanted to do an update video and just check in. I have three categories of updates for you today. First, work updates. Second, friend updates, or calling them stuff that I would want to talk about with my friends, like at a campfire. And the third is family updates. Here we go. Let's dive right in. I've missed you. First of all, number one, Vitamix spring sale. I'm not allowed to say that there will be a spring sale or when there will be a spring sale, Mother's Day sale in 2022, but for the past 5 years there has been, and it has begun right around the middle of April. So if you're waiting for a pretty good time to get a Vitamix, there's a pretty good chance that that's gonna be coming pretty soon. Most people take 3 to 6 weeks to fully appreciate the Vitamix, figure out which one they want. Best way to do that is to get on our email list. Intro to Vitamix will send you a few emails and keep you updated on when deals are live. Number two, there's a new product coming for Vitamix and we will be able to talk about it soon. Little hint, there are people that have been looking for a very specific Vitamix product. I wish Vitamix would make one of these with one of these. That's that product coming up. I think for people that have been holding out for a particular, you're gonna like it. Number three, the Vitamix One, the sort of 100 year anniversary little mini blender. It could do most things, but it couldn't do hot soups and it couldn't do nut butters. That product is being phased out. It was just a temporary celebratory thing and it's going away. So if you want one for your RV, your van life, something little, something for your mom or dad that's living alone, that's small, that's gonna perform really well, get one while you can. We really like the Vitamix One. If we had a van to put it in, we'd put it in that. Or if we were gifting someone a graduation gift for college, that would be the one too. The one. Work update number four, Vitamix has a new CEO. Jody Berg is retiring after a handful of years. This will be the first non-family member to lead Vitamix into the new era. The new CEO, his name is Steve. We are gonna meet him soon on a visit. So if there's things you'd like to know about him, his plans for the future of the company, be like talking to Tim Cook. As of this moment, reconditioned standard programs, these are basically the certified reconditioned 5200s with programs. A very popular model at a very good price point. They are available now on Vitamix.com. They're back in stock. They have some more of them. Link in the description. Update number six, you guys should make a cookbook. Well, we kind of did. It's called the Pain in the Mouth Cookbook. It's for orthodontists and oral surgeons to give to their patients after they proverbially punch them in the face and tighten their braces or extract a tooth. It's only available from your orthodontist or your oral surgeon. So you'll have to ask them, say, hey, do you guys get the Pain in the Mouth cookbooks? And then they'll have to reach out to the paininthemouthcookbook.com and say, hey, maybe we should get some custom Pain in the Mouth cookbooks for our orthodontist or oral surgeon practice. The last work update before we move on to fireside chat stuff, 1K30 is our new diet plan. We have a program we've made. It's our 10 years of work. It's the most important project we've ever done in our life. It's the diet plan where all you need is a Vitamix to lose weight. It's everything we've talked about over the last years boiled down into a 30-day plan. Go to 1k30.com and check it out. You won't be one of the first ones to do it. We've had lots of people go through and it's got a really cool feature unlike any 30-day plan that I know of. I'm not gonna tell you what it is. I want you to go to the site and see it. It has to do with the price and kind of how it's structured. Go there, 1k30.com. We're really excited about it. Before we move on, I just wanna say that it feels like sort of some of the darkness is over, and that's kind of the theme of today, in that we make some of our best videos. We, green juice and detox salad and queso. We put those together in the summertime when we have the time, when we're feeling inspired to do this. For the last 5 or 6 months, it's felt like we've been in a cloud of darkness and winter and baby and Omicron. And so we're excited that for what's to come, big important videos on our channel. So subscribe, to our channel if you want updates of that. Okay, let's talk about some other stuff. Fireside chat. This is stuff I just like to talk about, stuff that I would talk about with peers of mine. I think this is item number 8. I've been really hampered by making videos that are wanting them to be perfect, and perfect videos have been the enemy of pretty great videos. And so that's kind of why I'm here today. It's nice to be back talking to you guys, seeing your faces. This is number 9. This book, Hunt, Gather, Parent. Super awesome for parents, for grandparents. I never thought I would need a parent book or read a parent book. This is the first one Shaw and I ever needed or read, but this one has changed our lives and made our kids more helpful and gracious and appreciative and grateful and just better citizens, people we want to hang with. Stuff that I think comes more naturally for people in communities where there's more family around, there's a bigger house with multi-generations, there's a lot of helpers, and challenges that people in Western civilizations have that are in a house with mom, dad, and 2 or 3 kids. This book was awesome. Hunt, Gather, Parent. I might even do a whole video on it. It's just the best. I just switched payroll providers. That's boring. Gusto is cheaper and easier and better than what I had before. Productivity trick, the note card thing where you use a note card every day for the stuff that you want to get done. I've been trying it and it hasn't ever really stuck until now. I figured out the trick to it. The idea is that you put the one big thing you want to get done for the day and then a few small things. So there's space to write as you come up with stuff that you want to add to your big project. And then like, as you go through your day, you cross stuff off and you get that dopamine hit of crossing off the little tasks and retrain your brain to get dopamine hits from crossing stuff off. Let me go get a completed one. I mean, it's like so satisfying. So I carry this around with me in my pocket. I got the date and then I have 1 and then 2, 3, 4, 5 and then subtasks for the 1. Cross them off throughout the day. And then at the end of the day, you go through, you rip it up, and you throw it away. I think this is number 12, the iPhone hack I just figured out, or I just saw on a TikTok. You can set it so you double tap your phone to do something. So it's an accessibility hack, but basically if I double tap my phone, now the flashlight turns on, off. It's good to have chats like this, and back to the theme of the video, it's still cold and dreary out, and it feels like it has been the last 5 or 6 months. But the seasons always change. Winter always goes away, and it always gets warm. And that's what I keep telling myself. Let's go somewhere else to chat about family stuff. Update number 13. We had a few kid eating milestones recently. So our youngest started eating baby food, really any food that we give her. The second, our middle child, for the first time, ate our pancakes. We have a video about our oatmeal pancakes made with aquafaba. He loved them. He's kind of a picky eater, textures. Our oldest, our 4-year-old, began to ate spring rolls, and more than just eating mango and maybe a bite of tofu. Now he eats a spring roll with avocado and maybe a little red pepper. The spring rolls were one of our favorite things, and they make me feel like spring is here and soon. It's definitely not a winter meal, and it's nice that, you know, they say you gotta offer kids food like 20 times before they accept it, or you know if they actually won't accept it. So we just kept offering, and the way that he eats spring rolls has grown. So those are 3 kid eating milestones we're proud of. Update number 14, Shalva and I turned 37 this coming month, April 4th and April 17th. We're not kids anymore. We feel like we're like 30, 31. Definitely not close to 40.
But we know we don't look like we did when we were 27. And that's okay. We feel like we've been catching our groove with dinners, like kid dinners. Two I want to tell you about. Our Caesar salad has been a hit with the kids. We serve that with Nugs brand Nugs. Salad and Nugs has been huge. And then queso for dinner. We made a video on this. And we have sort of an adult version of that. We'll bake a sweet potato and throw queso all over it. So it's more than just celery, carrots, broccoli dipped in queso. It's actually a sweet potato with all sorts of good stuff on top. And finally, the last update is, well, you. Love to hear what's good with you. Leave a comment. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys. Life is no yoke.
It's an accessibility hack, but basically, if I double tap my phone, now the flashlight turns on. Oh, fail. Oh, come on. Come on. Is it because I'm in focus mode? There we go. Okay. It doesn't work super well because I have rise to wake turned off. It basically makes your phone less exciting to pick up. So like when I pick it up, it stays black. So you have to do this to turn it to wake it up. And then, come on, you're embarrassing me. Oh man, it's because I'm in work mode. What is happening? On. Oh my gosh. You're embarrassing me. All right, maybe if I turn it on. Work off. Is that okay? Wow. That wasn't so easy. Let's try one more time. On. Off. Oh boy. Well, that was fun.